Plants are vital to human survival. They provide the air we breathe, shelter, they provide our clothing, they provide our medicines. None of us would be here without them. But they're very vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. So global food security is a huge issue at the moment. We really need to find smarter ways of providing food for the future.
What we see now is a lot of new techniques. So the role of biotechnology is going to be key to enabling green transition in agriculture, as well as to mitigate the climate crisis. Plants are like humans. They stress. Any kind of stress can have an impact onto the plant's development or growth.
Abiotic stresses such as drought, erratic rain, or heat waves are leading to productivity loss for many farmers all around the globe. By the end of the century, 25% of the global harvest will be at risk. The yields are already under pressure, and with the global population only increasing, we clearly need to see more resilient crops if we want to find a solution. Farmers are having to adapt their practices. So we've set up Fyteko in order to help reduce the chemical inputs in agriculture.
So my name is Guillaume Aigria. I'm a CEO and co-founder of Fyteko. Fyteko is a biotech startup which is developing new bio-based active ingredient.
There are different ways that we can make crop more resilient. Either you need to modify all the genes, or you boost the natural mechanism that all plants have and enable the full genetic potential of the crop.
And so our technology is really inspired by nature. What we're doing is just mimicking the same response than the crop would have if there's a drought.
Our biotechnology really works with a single active ingredient, a single molecule, which is present and produced by the crop in a very tiny quantity, but only when they're facing the drought conditions.
So we produce them using green chemistry,
but at a bigger scale.
Nurse seed and nurse spray are our two biostimulant formulations. Nurse seed is applied as a seed treatment and nurse spray as a foliar spray on plants. So from early stages of germination and growth, seedlings will be receiving signals which allow the natural defense of the plant against abiotic stresses. We try to simulate some climatic stresses in the lab so that we can study how the plant reacts when it's treated or not with our product. But also in real production on different crops under different climatic conditions. The objective is to reduce the amount of conventional products applied in fields, so that's why we worked with bio-based technology that are safe for the environment.
The key advantage of this technology compared to standard agrochemicals
is that it's a naturally occurring molecule which is present in the crop that you eat normally.
They're not pesticides because they're not addressing any kind of pathogen, and they're not a fertilizer because they're not a nutrient.
So you can apply it on the canopy, on the seed, or even on the root system in the soil.
So our biotechnology solutions are really helping to reduce yield loss in case of droughts and helping global food security.
Water is really scarce in some region like in Africa. And sometimes they don't have access to irrigation.
We told Fyteko that we wanted a seed treatment to protect seedlings from water stress, or specifically for vegetable seeds adapted to tropical areas. I am Clémence Duval, Head of Seed Technology for Technisem. Technisem is a seed company specialized in vegetable seeds adapted to tropical areas. The areas where Technisem distributed seeds are the most affected by climate change. We have to provide the most adapted varieties to adapt to the extreme conditions and to ensure food security. The early stages of development are very important to the development of the crops. We applied Nursing Max on several plant species, the most sensitive to water stress, to optimize the genetic potential of our seeds. With Fyteko's technology, we show that it is possible to find natural solutions for agriculture. There is an appetite of innovation from the young African farmers. It provides a solution for all vegetable species. Therefore, it contributes to safer agriculture and food security in Africa.
Biotechnology has the potential to really increase global food production.
Water is getting scarce. We need to really find the best way to use the resource that we have currently on Earth. It's not only climate change, it's also the use of our resource today.
So new biotechnologies such as our single molecule can help to mitigate the risk of climate change in agriculture.
I think an increasing recognition from everybody about the role of plants within their lives is vital. We have the answers to the next agricultural revolution, whether that's for food security or adapting agriculture to climate change. There's just so much potential out there, and we have to move as quickly as we can.